Hi everyone, welcome back. Sorry I don't have a proper intro for you, but today I'm reviewing the new CoverGirl True Blend Matte Made Foundation. This is what the packaging looks like. They literally sent me every shade in this foundation and I was shook. Do people still say that word? I don't know. I'm turning 30 next week. So these are the foundations. They have L10 to L90, M10 to M90, T10 to T90, and D10 to D90. I'm just gonna go ahead and assume it only makes sense that the L stands for light, M stands for medium, T stands for tan, and D stands for deep. So this is what the foundation looks like close up. They claim that this is a 12-hour wear. They have 40 shades, which is amazing. That's always a plus. It's pore minimizing, transfer resistant, and it's supposed to control your oils. So we shall see. And I'm also gonna swatch all these shades for you guys so you can see what they look like. So wish me luck. I'm gonna start with pulling my hair away from my face so we can apply the foundation without any hair getting in the way. And the hair tie I'm using is this right here. My hairdresser gave this to me yesterday. I guess this is supposed to prevent any creasing in your hair. It literally looks like a keychain thing to me, but I tried it yesterday and it worked. So I guess it's worth it. Oh my God, this thing is so heavy. It's literally like 50 pounds. They sent me every shade of the foundation in here. Okay. I can't do this. Okay, since the box is so heavy, I literally can't lift it up. I'm not even exaggerating. I'm just gonna film it while the box is on the ground so you can see all the shades. And this box did come with primers too. At first, I wasn't gonna use a primer because I just wanted to test out the foundation that way. But since it comes with primers, I'm gonna be, oh my God, I'm out of breath. That's how you can tell I haven't worked out in so long. So the two primers I'm gonna be using today are these right here. So this one is the Skin Smoothing Primer, and this one is the Pore Minimizing Primer. This is gonna go all over my face, and this is gonna be on the center of my face because my pores are on my cheeks, nose, chin, but not as bad as my cheeks. So I'm gonna start with this one first. I'm gonna be applying this all over my face with my finger. So this is just a white primer. Okay, let's blend that and see how the finish is. It smells really good, actually, like really good. My camera just died on me in the middle of my primer, so I'm gonna finish applying this. So some on my cheek, forehead, nose, and everywhere else. The scent in this primer smells very familiar. I just can't remember what it is. It smells very floral. Next I'm gonna be taking the pore minimizing primer. I think this is purple because the tube looks purple. Yep, it's purple. So it's just gonna go on my nose. This smells just as good. On my pores. Okay, why do I have black? Oh my God, there's black eyeshadow. No! All right, now moving on to the foundation. I have so many options, so it's gonna be hard picking my shade. When picking my foundation, I always gravitate more towards foundations that have yellow undertones. I just feel like it looks better on my skin. I have olive skin. On camera, it does look dark, but in person, I just love how yellow foundations look on my skin. That might sound weird, but I just like that look. So let's find my foundation. I'm gonna take you back on my floor because I'm not picking this up. Let's go. All right, so this is what the foundation looks like. I grabbed shade M10, so hopefully that matches. If it doesn't, we're just gonna go back and pick a different shade. This is a matte foundation and it's supposed to stay on 12 hours, but I can't be wearing this for 12 hours. So I'm gonna keep this on my face as long as I can, and then I'm gonna come back and update you guys. Before we start, I just wanna tell you about my skin. I have really, really dry skin. My T-zone tends to get oily, but right now my skin is dry all over. And the primers I just used on my face are already very dry. They made my skin very matte. Maybe that wasn't a good idea for somebody who has dry skin, but I just wanted to use their primers with their foundation so we can see how they work together. So this foundation is 1 fluid ounce. I'm gonna find out how much it is and I'm gonna put it somewhere right here on the screen. It comes with a little cap. You open it up, it also comes with a pump, and that's always a plus. I think every foundation should have a pump. It's just cleaner, better. So let's test it out on the back of my hand. Oh, it has a lock, so that's another plus. So I'm just gonna unlock it and start pumping. Okay, so this is what the shade M10, which is Golden Natural, looks like. Let's test it out on the side. It might be a little too light, but I'm just gonna blend it some more and see. Actually, it might work because it's kind of matching my neck. I'm gonna go one shade darker just to see the difference. Okay, I grabbed M70, but that might be too yellow for me. So let's unlock it and see. All right, so this is what the M70 looks like. The M70 is sand beige. Am I in focus? Let me see. It matches my hand because, like I said in my last video, I tanned my body except my face. So I'm gonna apply this a little higher. I actually think this will work better, the M70, just because it's giving me a little bit of a tan and it's also matching the rest of my body. So I'm gonna put it all over this side of my face on top of the M10. Let me turn my brightness down so we can see better. Okay. Yeah, I think this shade is it. So M70, it is. Okay, so this foundation feels really good on my skin. From what I can tell, just by using it for 1 minute, it does not look cakey at all. It looks very natural. I'm gonna show you guys a close-up look so you can see the difference between this side of my face and this side. Oh my god, I am so pale. Look at that. Okay, so let me show you a closer look. So this is the side with the foundation, obviously. And this is what the other side looks like. I feel like I should get closer. Okay guys, I don't know if I can get closer than this. My table is literally in my stomach. The table in front of me. Okay, now I'm gonna finish the rest of my face. Oh, wrong side. I'm gonna speed it up a little bit so it's not boring. I'm gonna apply foundation in my hairline too because I'm trying to cover the hair dye right here. I dyed my hair yesterday. Well, I didn't dye it, but I got my hair dyed yesterday. And there's some hair dye left on my forehead, so I'm trying to cover that. All right, now that I'm done with the foundation, I'm gonna move on to concealer. I'm gonna use a concealer from CoverGirl because might as well, since we're already using CoverGirl primer foundation, let's just use the concealer too. This is actually my first time using this too, so we're just gonna twist this. I think I'm supposed to hold it like this.
3 hours later.
Ah! Okay. That's what it looks like. This concealer is not as thick as I wanted it to be, but let me blend it out and see. Yeah, it's very sheer, I can already tell. I like my concealers to be very thick and bright, but I'm still gonna blend it out on both sides and see what it looks like. We're just on a roll today because I'm gonna use the CoverGirl powder as well. I'm gonna set my face with this. I'm just gonna lightly use it because I still wanna see how the foundation is gonna turn out or how long it's gonna last. So I'm literally just dabbing it in there and just lightly setting my face some more underneath my eyes. And this is in the shade 725, which is buff beige, and I'm using my Morphe G8 brush. All right, so this is it for the foundation and powder part. I'm gonna go apply my bronzer, blush, lipstick, and all of that, and then I'll be back in a few hours to update you guys on the foundation, so stay tuned. Hey guys, I'm back. So it's been a few hours now. Sorry if my lighting is bad, my room is dark right now. I took off my lipstick because I was eating earlier. So after I finished filming my video, I went in the kitchen, started cooking some food. So I was kind of running around in the house with my makeup on. And after that, I went to a friend's house for a barbecue. So we were sitting outside the whole time. It was a few hours. And after I left, the first thing I did when I sat in my car was pull down my mirror, turn on the light, and check out my makeup. And honestly, it still looked the same. And now that I'm here in my room looking at my mirror, looking at my monitor, it still looks the same. And my foundation still looks matte. Normally my T-zone would get really oily. I'm just so impressed with this. So like I said, if you guys are looking for a new drugstore foundation, I highly recommend this one. So make sure you check it out. Try it out. Let me know how you like it. And you can come back to this video or message me on Instagram, Snapchat, whatever you want, and let me know how that worked out for you. I would love to hear your feedback. And yeah, this is it for my video. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.